India is one of the largest buyers in global arms market, including warplanes. However, in recent years, the government has been actively working to strengthen our own military industries. In this video, we will discuss the problems and prospects along with the possible solutions. How did India master rocket technology but fails to make a fighter jet engine? From a complete layman's perspective, rocket propulsion is much simpler in design than a constantly reusable jet engine to understand more. First, let's understand what is a jet engine. A jet engine is a type of reaction engine discharging a fast-moving jet that generates thrust by jet propulsions. They are one of the most challenging and complex missions ever made. Imagine a blade rotating at 35,000 rpm in a temperature of 1200 Celsius and also withstanding all kinds of mechanical and aerodynamic stress. Such complexity have resulted in only 5 to 6 companies having a known who to do it correctly. Jet engines are incredibly difficult to produce. They are by far the hardest and most complicated part of a fighter aircraft to build. Only a handful of nations could manage to develop modern fighter jet engines after decades of experience, trial, huge expense, infrastructure and ambition. Fighter jet engine is one of the most challenging missions ever made, which are Germany, Russia, UK, France and USA. America's first jet engine was based entirely on a top secret British design. Well, in China, almost the entire modern fighter fleet have either borrowed liberally from or directly copied foreign models. However, it's safe to assume that within a decade, China will completely self-sufficient in the sector. The Indian multi-role fighter program was launched back in 1983, but the first flight of the Tejas-like multi-role fighter took place only in 2001, and the contract for the supply of the Indian Air Force first 40 serial aircraft, all Tejas, was signed only in 2012. Of course, as many experts note, Tejas is almost every respect inferior to modern fighters produced in United States, Europe or Russia. Nevertheless, the Indian leadership is not going to stop work on further improvement of its own aircraft, which does not cancel the purchase of foreign-made fighter jets. Recently, UK Minister for Defence Procurement James Happy announced India and the UK are exploring various options for collaboration on joint defence projects and are close to signing a government-to-government agreement on jet engine technology development. The success of both the Kaveri and Tejas programs will transform the aerospace scene and put India in the front of ranks of aeronautical nations, perhaps even ahead of China if the desired degree of resolve and professional rigors can be brought to the fore. If we miss this opportunity, we will remain abjectly import dependent forever in this vital area. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe for more.